Oh, the late game, Packers and the 49ers. These two teams played earlier in the season in San Francisco, and the 49ers completely spanked Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers, and Rodgers played terribly in the game. Now, you can also make the case the 49ers are better now than they were then. They played a great game last week. And if you're going to go by the quarterbacks, obviously Aaron Rodgers is better at this point than Jimmy Garoppolo. But, boy, to me, the 49ers have the total package. They have a great defense. Their offensive is innovative. I have looked all year. I don't know if you guys agree. You probably don't. I think that the Green Bay Packers are an overvalued stock. I just don't think they're as good as people think they are. They just haven't blown me away. Now, it's a big number. Rodgers is 36 years old. This could be one of his last chances to get back to the Super Bowl. I get all of that. But convince me how the Packers win this game.
I don't think I can, because I think the 49ers are a better team. But the number's still 7.5. And as much as the Packers are overrated, I agree with you. I don't think they're a championship team. When you look at the end of that game against Seattle, things are falling apart for the Packers. You just got a sense that Seattle was going to win that game. And what did Aaron Rodgers do? Not once, but twice. Converts on big third and longs to keep the ball, run the clock out, hold on and win the game. He is a special quarterback. So as much as I don't think they're good enough to win the game, he's a quarterback that I think can keep them in the game. And Garoppolo hasn't played well. You know, that defense masked a lot of errors. They had turnovers in that game that Minnesota just couldn't take advantage of because Cousins was brutal in the game. But it wasn't like Jimmy G had a historic game either. So there's something about a championship game on the verge of a Super Bowl. You've got to give Green Bay a little bit of an edge at quarterback just because of who Aaron Rodgers is. He's been there. He's done that. Now, I think San Francisco's defense will eventually win the day, but I could see the Packers hanging in this one and the 49ers just being the better team win. But that 7.5 number scares me, Michael, because I could see Green Bay hanging around here. And, you know, we'll see how it plays out from there. Now, if you listen to what R.J. Bell said yesterday, is that the 49ers' defense was exhausted. Their bye came in week 4. So a lot of the ills of their defense late in the season came from them being exhausted. They went right back to what they were coming out of the bye. So playing one extra game shouldn't kill them. So I would think their defense will be strong when it needs to be strong. But, Peter, Jimmy G wasn't great. That defense did give up the long touchdown after San Francisco had taken the 7-0 lead. I think Rodgers is a better quarterback than Cousins. I don't think they can win, but I think they can hang.
So obviously the game that we will everyone will look back at is that 37-8. Destruction a few weeks ago. Must be pointed out that the Packers lost Bulaga early, had a backup right tackle the entire game, who was matched up against Nick Bosa. That without question, changes that game big time for Aaron Rodgers. So let's get rid of the idea that this game is going to look like that. I think that losing Bulaga alone is enough to completely disrupt that team and change the way they look. Aaron Rodgers, statistically right now, there's a ridiculous stat here, is among the four quarterbacks left, the lowest in passer rating, completion percentage, yards per attempt.
Aaron Rodgers, you said?
Last of the four quarterbacks.
Really?
Left. And passing touchdowns per game. He's last in every one of those categories. This has not been a typical Rodgers year.
And that's why what Don said, you know, he moved the chains when he had to. Because his receivers made really great plays. I don't think he played that great in that win last week.
I thought the last drive, he truly was Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah, he dropped that one ball in.
That was beautiful.
Yeah.
But let's be clear. Davante Adams was the MVP of that game, probably. I mean, he got a lot of help. So, but I believe there's an opportunity when you have a player as great as Aaron Rodgers. He knows what this means. It's been 9 years since he's been there, and he knows very well he may not get back again. So I will be shocked and disappointed if the Packers do this week what they've done so many weeks this season.
And lay an egg.
That is play. No, lay an egg from late in the second quarter to the middle of the fourth quarter. I have seen this so many times with them. They start out looking good. They move right down the field. Don, you remember that terrible game when I had picked the Bears to cover against the Packers and Trubisky was fighting desperately and almost came all the way back. It came down to one last flea flicker that almost ended up tying the game late. They did that, I feel like, half the games this season. You know, they were 13-3, and I feel like in 7 or 8 of those 13 wins, they sat around waiting for the other team to come back. If they do that against the 49ers team, they are losing this game.
Now, your clown friend Ballard